This does not pretend to be the best way to modify Nvidia drivers. It's just what I personally prefer. On that premise, if you want to follow along, download NVCleanstall from TechPowerUp. Run it, and you'll be greeted by this first screen. Here, the desired driver version can be selected automatically, manually, or extra manually. I favor this latter because I carefully elect it on the basis of the release notes on Nvidia's website, so as to avoid unnecessary updates. Anyway, download the one that suits you, open it, and leave these last options alone, as I reckon that running software on demand is best. Now, which components to install? My policy is simple. None except those you actually use. Do you play physics games? Is your graphics card connected to speakers via HDMI, DP, or DVI? Do you want to add runtimes that you most likely already have? Are you working on a laptop? Is your VGA equipped with a USB-C port? Do you use a framework to log and/or display hardware stats on screen? Do you own a professional card and create virtual desktops? Do you own a Shield wireless controller? For those questions, you have answered yes. Tick the corresponding box. As for the GeForce Experience components, well, you're here to debloat the drivers, aren't you? In my book, these are bloat by definition, so non ragioniam di lor, ma guarda e passa, as we say. After the unpacking process, it is time for tweaking, and for my new policy. Don't be overzealous. So let's delve into the details of all the options and decide which are worth selecting. First, the self-explanatory ones. Disable installer telemetry and ads. Yep. Unattended express installation. Nope. Be patient. Enable a DLSS indicator, if you need it. Then the other three, which are less clear-cut. Do you want to start from scratch by factory resetting the NVCP, game profiles included? Do you want to force officially unsupported but technically compatible drivers on your card? A typical example would be forcing drivers on a notebook GPU locked by the manufacturer. Does your monitor suffer from sporadic flickering, black and/or gray screens? These issues seem to be more common with high resolution and refresh rates on multi-display configs. Finally, the expert tweaks. As a general rule, I'd avoid any experimental features. Although the patch that removes restrictions on the maximum number of concurrent NVENC sessions imposed by Nvidia to consumer GPUs could be useful to somebody. Nevertheless, let's focus on the other four options. Select the first to prevent the audio driver from putting your monitor or TV speakers into a deep sleep state after 4 seconds of inactivity, from which they may not be able to wake up. Select the second to switch from line-based to message-signaled interrupts, which might reduce interrupt latency and thus stuttering, audio crackling, and the like. Note that, on some configs, MSI is already enabled. To verify, open the Device Manager, Display Adapters, double-click on your card, Resources, scroll down, Negative IRQ, if so, it's enabled. In case it's not, I'd suggest leaving Affinity and Priority at default, since these are the safest choices. Select the third to remove the ability to play protected videos, which could further reduce latency. Beware that then it won't be possible to watch streaming services and Blu-rays. Select the fourth to start an app before and/or after installation, which I don't see the point of, but for some it may very well exist. To complete the modding procedure, click on the second button and copy-paste the contents of the temporary folder wherever you like. Lastly, click on setup.exe to actually install the new drivers, or uninstall the old one first via DDU, if you deem it necessary. Then reboot, and you're done. Many thanks for tuning in and fare you well for now.